Hello friends, our today's topic is rectifiers. Here we are going to see the introduction of rectifiers. Rectifiers are the important application of the diode. It converts alternating current AC to direct current DC. Rectifier is an essential circuit in AC to DC power supply design. In order to power any electronic devices, a power supply is needed. The power is from an AC supply. So AC to DC conversion is required. So a rectifier is needed. Figure shows a schematic diagram of a DC power supply. AC line that feeds the power supply. It delivers a output voltage VO to the electronic circuit, that is load block. The output voltage must be a stable DC voltage to ensure that the electronic circuitry functions correctly. The figure consists of several blocks. The input side AC mains, that is AC mains is given to the transformer, transformer to the rectifier circuit, rectifiers to filter, filter to the regulator, then the output DC output. The transformer, rectifier, filter are unregulated power supply. The unregulated power supply output is given to the regulator, that is our GNR. The GNR output is a regulated power supply. We are having the DC output. First, we are going to see the transformer. A transformer is a step down transformer that steps down the high AC voltage to a lower AC voltage to be inputted to the rectifier. Consists of two separate coil windings, that is primary and secondary windings, have a different number of turns, N1 for the primary side and N2 for the secondary side. So the AC mains is given to the transformer. Transformer output is step down voltage. That step down voltage is connected to the rectifier circuit. The rectifier is mainly designed using diode. So the rectifier converts alternating current AC to a DC voltage. DC voltage will exhibit large variations and thus will not be suitable for electronic circuitry. The rectifier output is given to the filter. In generally, filter means to remove the unwanted things. Here, the filter is used to smooth out these variations. That is, the output of the rectifier has some variations to remove the variations. Even after filtering, though, the voltage will exhibit small variations known as ripple. The next filter output is connected to the regulator, voltage regulator. The voltage regulator is used to greatly reduce the ripple and establish a reliable DC supply rail. So from the figure, AC mains connected to the transformer. The transformer output is a step down output as shown in the figure. Then connected to the rectifier. The rectifier output is a unidirectional output. The sinusoidal wave to a one side positive waveforms only. That positive waveforms output will connect to the filter. The filter having the small variations. That variations is called a ripple. That ripple can be smoothened in the regulator circuit, voltage regulator circuit. The final output is a stable DC output voltage. Next, rectifiers types. So, rectifiers are converting AC to DC. Here the rectifiers are half wave rectifiers, full wave rectifiers and bridge rectifiers. Half wave rectifier. Half wave rectifier eliminates the negative portion of the input sinusoid or eliminates positive portions of the input sinusoid depending upon the diode connection. Full wave rectifier. Unlike the half wave rectifier, it can utilize both the negative and the positive portion of the AC input voltage. In order to achieve a unipolar output, the negative portion of the sinusoidal waveform must be inverted. That is a special characteristic of the full wave rectifier. Next one is bridge rectifier. The circuits, the diodes arranged in the bridge circuit connection comprises of four or more number of diodes which cause the output generated to be the same polarity irrespective of the polarity at the input. So far we have discussed the what is rectifier, where the rectifiers are used and types of rectifiers. Thank you.